Welcome to this presentation of our paper, Automatic Detection of Noise Events at Shooting Range Using Machine Learning. My name is Jon Nørby, and I'm presenting on behalf of my co-authors Fabian Nemasi and Dag Ryber. This work was a collaboration between Sound Sensing and Politiets Nasjonale Beredskapssenter, or PNB for short. PNB is a combined training facility and operative base for the police special forces in Norway. It's located in close proximity to Oslo Center and the surrounding urban area to ensure quick response time. It has an outdoor shooting ranges for firearm training, 100 meters, 50 meters, and 200 meters, and training facilities for explosives training. Around 1.2 kilometers to the west and to the north of the site, there are residential areas. This is relatively close for this kind of facility. A large amount of resources has therefore been put into ensuring that the noise impact is minimal. This includes careful design of the shooting ranges and the construction of large earth walls and noise barriers. The site operator also wants to be able to log the activity at the training site that potentially creates noise in order to respond to requests from the public. The facility also has a helicopter landing pad, but helicopter noise was not included in this project as it was considered well monitored through the aviation logbooks. Being a shooting range, PNB is subject to national regulations in Norway, which requires LDN to be below 35 decibels and LAF max to be below 65 decibels at residential areas. And also there are local regulations for PNB, which says that training activity shall only occur between 07 in the morning and 27 in the evening, on Monday to Friday. And there is a yearly limit of 2,000 noise events, primarily gunshots, and a yearly limit of 1,250 explosive charges outdoors. And this requires additional functionality from the noise monitoring system. So the goal of this project was to test whether sound sensing sensors using machine learning can provide automatic logging of noisy periods from shooting and training and explosives training, and two, count the number of impulsive noise events, and three, count the number of outdoor explosives only separated from the gunshots. And the main requirements were that privacy is preserved and that there is a low number of sensors required. We collected data during the construction of the site before operations had started. The noise maps that were calculated were tested using the protocol from Norwegian guidelines M128, and one gunshot or explosive was fired per 30 seconds in series of 5 or 10 events. This was done in worst case weather condition in terms of noise propagation and the most noisy weapon configurations, locations and directions. We placed one recording unit at a central location in the middle of the picture here, and also one recording unit at each of the individual training areas. We found early on that recordings from the central unit picked up all events with good clarity. So all data analysis was done only with a single sensor data. To simulate more realistic operating conditions, including higher density of gunshot events and occasional overlap of events, the dataset was synthesized by mixing the original noise events with different backgrounds. We set the loudness of the synthesized noise events to be the same or lower as the originals to ensure that the task is hard to reflect the more challenging conditions. And we used the scraper software tool for this. As a simple baseline, we computed the sound levels and applied random forest and logistic regression classifiers. The sound levels were split into 1 second windows with 125 milliseconds hop between consecutive windows. We hand engineered some features for each window that are representative of impulsive noises. For example, the maximum noise, the minimum, the maximum of the first order difference, which captures the leading edge of the impulsive noise, and the minimum of the first order difference, which captures the trailing of the impulsive noise, as well as the difference in maximum level with respect to the background. These were put into the classifier as independent windows. The other model we tested was convolutional neural network on spectrogram representation. We used 1/3 octave spectrograms with 128 millisecond resolution, which has been shown to provide privacy and not allow speech to be reconstructed. Spectrograms were also divided into 1 second lengths with 125 milliseconds hop. And each of these windows went into the convolutional neural network model. Here there is no hand coding of impulsive noise features. These were the results. In orange, we see the logistic regression on sound level performing the worst, the simplest model. Random forest did considerably better in green. However, the best model was the convolutional neural network, which reached on the window-wise evaluation an F1 score of 76.4%. Since each event might be covered by multiple overlapping windows, we also computed an event-wise score, which is the more important score. And here, the best model, the convolutional neural network, reached an F1 score of 80.5, with a precision of 95.5, which is very good, and a recall of 69.6, which is not so good. Since training events are almost always clustered together in normal operations, we don't need to catch everyone. This means that with this high precision, although the recall is a little bit low, this is sufficient for detecting periods with activity. However, the low recall means that one cannot precisely count the number of events with this model, and this requires further work. The main outcome of the project is that the system for noise monitoring will be put into operation, running from the second half of 2021. The main functionality is an automated logbook created based on these models that show the times with training activity versus no training activity. And this will be used to respond to information requests from the public. And the next steps are to deploy the system. We have already installed the sensors. And here is some data from these sensors showing typical operation. And we will validate the performance with this real operations data, as well as do user testing of the logbook and monitoring system overall. We also plan to research more around this topic. For example, we are testing automatic ways to determine how much noise is experienced at the surrounding residential area. Our problem statement is, given noise experienced at the receiver in the residential area, does it originate from our source, A at PMB, or does it come from other background sources? This will build on the automatic detection of noise events at the source, which we have developed in this work. And initial results are already available in Fabian de Masi's master thesis, Determining the Origin of Impulsive Noise Events Using Wireless Sound Sensors. So, if you have a noise monitoring challenge that could benefit from automatic detection, we are looking to test out this technology on other use cases, such as industrial noise, construction noise, traffic, and social noise. Thank you for your time.